So last weekend, I was teaching a workshop in Chicago, and I had a client. The very first night we took him out, you know, we were helping him. This is the first night we're trying to find out base level for him. So as the night's going on, we're trying to, you know, tweak a few things here and there. As the night's going on, he approaches a woman and has a very good interaction. She's totally into him. She's almost ready to kiss him. And I know that she's ready to kiss him because, you know, her lips are like 1 inch away from his lips. She's literally leaning in, wanting to be kissed. And at that point, the client ended up asking him if she would like to be kissed, and she ended up saying no. When he came back, I told him, you know, I asked him why did he not kiss her, and he told me that he ended up asking her instead, and she refused to kiss. And I told him, of course, she refused to kiss because until that point, she was really enjoying that you were taking the lead. You know, you approached her, you generated all the attraction. Now she's ready for the kiss. She's giving you all the signs. But at this point, instead of showing dominance, you showed weakness by asking her. And I find that this is something that's very common that happens to men at different levels of interaction. A lot of men think that, you know, in their head, they have a lot of these ideas of what's respectful and what's disrespectful to women. And I tell you, there is no such thing. There are no rules or guidelines what makes something disrespectful versus something respectful. Only two people can decide. It's only that interaction between the man and the woman that dictates what's going to be respectful and what's going to be disrespectful. So it's less about what you're doing. It's more about when you're doing it and how you're doing it. I'll give you a couple of instances. So for instance, I'm going to give you some over the top instances to make it clear. Like I'll give you an example. The same workshop that I was teaching, you know, I approached a woman and I started staring at her chest. Like she was wearing a hoodie with the name of her school that she went to. And she started saying, oh, I went to this school. And I said, I'm not trying to read what school you went to. I'm actually looking at your boobs. And she started to laugh. She never found that to be disrespectful. Now, on the surface, walking straight up to a woman and staring at her breast and saying, I'm looking at your boobs, is pretty disrespectful. It's really treating women like a commodity. But the reason it was okay was because of the timing and the manner I did that. You see, before I approached her, I was talking to a lot of people at the venue. I'm a very loud, high energy kind of a guy, so everybody notices me. So this woman had already seen me having fun with other women, touching them, being playful with them, being silly around. So when I came and talked to her, it was okay because she, in her mind, she has already seen me as a silly guy, and she already sees my move as, you know, being a silly guy having fun with her. It wasn't like, you know, it didn't have that sexual innuendos of a creepy guy trying to do that. So a lot of these things are about two people. Only two people can dictate what's right or wrong. I'll give you another example. Sometime back I was teaching in LA, and there was a woman, you know, she made eye contact with me, started walking in my direction, and you know, we both never broke our eye contact. I would say about a feet before, or maybe a few inches before she reached me, all of a sudden she pushed her breast out to see if I was gonna be intimidated and if I'm gonna, you know, get, you know, move from her line, you know, move away from her as she was approaching me. And instead of walking away from her, instead of giving her space, instead of being intimidated, I instantly groped her boobs and said, oops, sorry, that was an accident. She instantly groped my penis and said, oops, that was an accident. But see, again, if I tell somebody to go and do that, it would be very wrong, it would be very inappropriate. This move can turn out to be disrespectful. But the reason, again, it wasn't disrespectful, because this woman and I already had a silent communication. We already made an eye contact, where even before she approached me, even before she got close to me, we both had established a friendly vibe. It was almost like, it's on, I'm gonna see. You know, it was almost like we both were testing who can really push the other person far off. Now again, this is not something that, you know, that could be taught to someone. This is something, it's an interaction that you have to learn. It's an experience. You have to learn to read other person. You have to learn to read social dynamics and figure out what's appropriate, what's not appropriate. And I find that this is something that limits a lot of men. You see, a lot of men are nice by heart, right? When they go out, they don't want to upset a woman. They don't want to step in their space. So I've seen men, I've seen clients, I've done it myself when I was learning, when I was a beginner, you know. I'll go out and I'll see two women walking by or sitting at a table and talking. I'll be like, oh, I don't want to disturb them because they're busy with their conversation. I don't want to be rude to step in, you know. I'll be at workplace or classroom and I would not want to approach the woman and make her feel uncomfortable. I would not put her in a situation of feeling discomfort to reject me. So I would rather not approach them. And what happens is after you get into this mindset for a very long time, you end up becoming that. You just accept the way of life of not to disturb other people. You assume that anytime you approach someone, anytime you try to take a chance, ask them out on a date, that you're doing something that is not okay, that somehow women don't want this to happen. Somehow this is disrespectful to women. And if you continue to do this for a long time, this becomes your lifestyle. And from there is no recovery. Then you know, there are too many problems that comes with it. Also, once you get used to living by yourself for a very long time, you actually stop, you start building wrong ideas about women and relationship. You also get used to isolation. So even when you get into relationship, it's really hard to be in a relationship because you're used to being by yourself. And I tell you, like, majority of the clients that come to my workshop are victim of this myth, are victim of this mindset. And I'm not suggesting here that you need to be aggressive or assertive or go out and start touching women, being gropey, or start saying things over the top. Those were just examples to, like, I wanted to use some extreme examples to give you an idea how even the most inappropriate thing could be appropriate when done right with the right person. What I'm suggesting here is that you start making changes and you start taking small steps to discover that a lot of the information that you have in your mind is actually a myth. And this is exactly what we do in our workshop. You see, when we take clients out in our workshop, that's what we're trying to see. We see when a guy goes and approaches a woman, what are the kind of things he says? What are the kind of things he feels comfortable in doing? And what are his limited beliefs that are holding him back? So one way or another, you have to find your limited beliefs, because I tell you, at every step of the interaction, I find it's the limited belief that's holding most men back. So, you know, if it's about approaching someone, a guy would be like, oh, I'm not good enough for a woman to talk to me. Or, oh, you know, those girls are way too good looking, they're never gonna talk to me. Oh, there's the guy in that group, so I cannot go and approach them. There's always some limited excuse, there's always some limited belief that they think that because of that, it's not okay to go and approach them, it's not okay to touch them, it's not okay to go for a kiss, not okay to ask them out for a date, you know, this instant. And I tell you, all of these rules change the minute you start talking to a person. Only two people can determine what their chemistry is. I'll give you another example. I was teaching in New York a couple of months back, and the very first night, my client's talking to, you know, two women, and at one point I was like, you know, I'm just gonna take her friend away so he can feel more comfortable. This is still the first night, he's not very well trained, so I'm like, but I texted him, I said, you know, this woman's ready to kiss you, I'm gonna take her friend away, make sure you kiss her while we are away. As I'm away, I'm talking to her friend, I said, I just wanted to take you away so my friend can kiss your friend. And she's like, my friend never kisses him, you know, the first time she meets a guy. I'm like, I don't know, I had a feeling he's going to kiss her, you know. Couple of minutes later, we look back and they both are making out. And I looked at her friend and said, excuse me, what did you just say about your friend not kissing anyone the first time they meet? And this is what I'm saying. People have their values. People have their stereotypes. People have their agendas. We read a lot of the stuff outside online. You know, we even hear a lot of stuff from women or men. What's okay, what's not okay. I will never sleep on the first date. I would never kiss a guy the first time I meet them. I don't like when men approach me. I don't like, you know, when I go to bars, people come and say this and that. All of those are general principles. What people are saying is, I don't like to do any of that stuff unless I really want it to happen to me. So most women do not want to be touched. Most women do not want to be kissed the first time they meet a guy unless they're really feeling strong, uncontrollable attraction for this guy. So when you go out, you know, or wherever you are, the thing that you need to do right now is you need to start by figuring the right belief system, the right myths, the right way people behave and operate. You need to understand all of that stuff. That's the first step. And the second step is you need to know what are those limited beliefs that you're holding on that limits you, that freezes you from going and approaching women, from talking to them, from interacting the things you want to say or do. And then start taking chances, you know, start going out and implementing. Here's the thing, man. No matter what you do, no matter what mistake you make, none of those mistakes are irreparable. There is, you know, if you approach a woman and you say something wrong, doesn't matter how inappropriate it is, you're not going to scar a woman for life. The worst case, she's going to have a bad experience with you for 5 minutes, she's going to get over it. You know, unless you go and start groping a woman and you become really aggressive, in which case you'll be thrown out of the venue. But majority of people who, you know, who watch my videos, majority of people that I have met who are my clients are usually socially calibrated. They're usually on the other side. They're usually holding back more than pushing forward. So that's what I'm saying. Take small chances. And if not, come to a workshop. Let us stand next to you and let us show you what's possible. Let us help you reframe your belief systems. Let us help you, you know, interact with women and show you how far you can push your interactions. How far can you go with women the first time you meet them? Let us teach you the things that you're missing or you're doing wrong. which is actually killing attraction with women. Like I said, I give you the example of this guy. The woman has her face right in front of him, and he still thinks that she's not ready for the kiss. And I asked him, what do you think the woman was going to do? You know, she has her lips 1 inch away from your lips for no other reason. What do you think? She was going to sing you a lullaby? No, she's there because she wants to be kissed by you. And it's these things, not knowing these rules, that most men lose their chances with women. Most men are afraid to socialize. Most men are afraid to stand apart. Most men lose these opportunities at workplace, in trains, in public places, to stand apart and generate attraction even before they approach women. And so I really wanted to take 3 things from this video. One, you know, learn how to be attractive to women even before you approach them. Like I said, women won't let you touch them. Women won't let you kiss them unless they want it to happen. So you have to figure out, how can you be attractive? How can you use the dynamics in your favor so women has attraction for you even before you approach them? And once you approach them, how to lead it to the next level? And for that, number two is you need to discover all the limited beliefs that are affecting you. So when you're with a woman, you're not coming across as needy. You're not losing attraction because you're not playing it by the right rules. And the third thing is, start taking chances, start taking small steps. You know, this is the only way you're going to learn. This is the only way you're going to improve. And we have great resources for you. You know, you can download. I have some of the best information systems that can tell you almost everything you need to know about the myths that are affecting you, about how to overcome the limitations that are holding you back to meet women. Or come to a workshop. Let me hold your hand and take you step by step. Let me show you what you're doing right, what you're doing wrong. Let me show you how women perceive you, and based on their perception, what's the best approach for you to generate attraction. Let me show you the small things, the small changes you need to make so you can have a strong impact on women, so you can really make women want to be with you. And once that happens, you will never be limited. Once you understand the social rules, once you understand how you're coming across to people, once you understand the things you need to do, how far you can take things, that is it. That is all it takes to get women, to build that lifestyle where you're always with women, where you're able to date, you know, attract and date quality women. So hope this helps, and I'll talk to you soon.